Charlie Brown.
I can't believe it.
Come on, Charlie Brown. I'll hold the ball and you'll kick it.
You'll pull it away and I'll land flat on my back.
But Charlie Brown, it's Thanksgiving.
Maybe I should do it. Besides, she wouldn't try and trick me on a traditional holiday. I'm gonna kick it to the moon.
Welcome to High Voltage, CBTV's very own entertainment show.
Coming up?
I'll be going around campus asking what your favorite Thanksgiving meal is.
We're gonna show you how to kick a soccer ball.
I'll be going around singing to people.
And I'll be trying to make my contestants laugh.
What's up, Cypress Bay? I'm Andrew Sobel.
And I'm Kimberly Blum.
High Voltage starts now.
So have you heard anything about this new show, High Voltage?
I've heard of it, but I don't know much about it.
Well, here's some information I gathered about working behind the scenes.
The television production course at Cypress Bay High School starts up a new show, High Voltage, so that its members and producers express their entertainment talents.
High Voltage. I'd be able to like use my management skills. I like to be able to be in charge, basically, and show that, like, to be able to put things together in a certain way that other people would not be able to put it into. So like being in charge of a show, being a producer, is kind of using management skills and time and all this other type skills to put things together. And then when I was able to apply, I was like, wow, this sounds really interesting because I can make the show what I want it to be rather than have to let someone that might not know what they're doing as much or maybe not have the same idea or not be able to get the input that maybe the whole entire class may want to put into the production.
With the show starting from a fresh slate, members are given more opportunities to express their creative side in their work.
I think being a producer on this show is actually pretty cool. I got to work with a lot of my friends who aren't dreading to work on their project. They can actually put the effort they want to put into it. They also are working together in groups this time, so it creates a lot less stressful environment, I think, for the people working on the segments.
The members in TV3 have had several challenges placed in front of them. Yet, as a team, they managed to work around it.
Right now we're working on the first episode, so I think the only difficulty that some of the crew members might be having is really deciding how they want to put their segment together in post-production rather than following like a specific format. I think that they have so much they have so much space to be creative, so they might be having some problems with how to put their segment together.
With all the crew of High Voltage motivated to continue the show, they hope to set an example for future years to come. Kimberly Blum, CBTV.
I've always wanted to be good at decorating cakes.
Yeah, it's pretty hard to perfect.
Here's Sabrina with the sweet surprise.
We're gonna use these things.
You guys are working as a team, and you have a single instruction now. Your instruction is to decorate a Thanksgiving-themed cake.
Oh.
And you have 15 minutes on the clock right now.
That is not a thing.
Let's go.
Didn't give us instructions for the show.
We had to stack it, right? It does not look good.
You don't look good.
Woo. It's fine, we got this. Never do that again.
So
don't taste raw vanilla. Can we get some more tissues?
Guys, don't make anything.
Oh,
please catch.
So, what do you think when you hear the words Thanksgiving?
Pilgrim's dying.
You're not wrong, actually. So we should draw an arrow representing death.
Wow.
Oh, that looks like blood.
No, this is green. Is that one green?
This is green.
That's light green. This is dark green.
I cannot with this. It's falling apart.
You literally broke it. Like,
It's falling.
This is botched.
It is not my fault. It is not my fault. It's falling apart.
You are stabbing it as you say that.
It is not my fault. I'm telling you, it is not my fault. I just keep on making this to run terrible, run this cake.
Most of the time, superficial things are not what matters. And what truly matters is what's within.
So this?
But sometimes even what's within is complete and utter garbage. I think it's perfect.
It's beautiful. We did it. We actually did it.
Did you know that even in Weston there are families in need?
Yeah, but the work that Cypress Bay and DEC has done is going to help so many of them.
That's true. Here's Angela with more on the Harvest Drive.
So Harvest Drive is basically a community-wide organization, and it feeds families and provides them with clothing and supplies for their homes all year round. But the biggest push is in the month of November, when Cypress Bay on its own collects 175 families worth of food for 10 days and including a Thanksgiving meal. But Harvest Drive in general as the organization feeds 2,400 families in and around Broward County. So what we do in past years and this year, of course, is that we delegate certain items to different clubs. That way the whole student body to really come forward and promote Harvest Drive and learn about what it is and why it's so important, and also participate hands-on in just donating food, whether it's one can of beans or like 20 cans of beans, everything makes a difference. So it's a really great way to get the whole student body involved and aware of this issue of just like food insecurity that's really more prominent in the areas surrounding Weston than you might think. The families that receive our food from the Harvest Drive donations are handpicked by social workers at each of the schools in the surrounding area. And they're families that might be going through, like they just lost a job or they aren't able to buy food at the moment. But the important thing to remember is that it could be your teacher or the student sitting next to you in class. It's really, you never know how close to home it's really hitting for the people around you in your community.
Hey Andrew, what's a pilgrim's favorite type of music?
I don't know. What is it?
Plymouth Rock.
Good one. Let's watch Eric in the ultimate face-off of corny Thanksgiving jokes.
This is Spit Take, and I'm your host, Eric Marone, and I'll be trying to make my contestants laugh with corny Thanksgiving jokes. Here we have Tyler and Zach. What does a pilgrim call his friends? Palgrims. What's the key to a fantastic Thanksgiving dinner? The turkey. What should you wear to Thanksgiving dinner? A harvest. How many cooks does it take to stuff a turkey? Only one, but you have to really squeeze them in. What always comes at the end of Thanksgiving? The letter G.
How do you know? The letter G.
He went to
swim. The letter G. Oh my god.
What happened when the turkey got in a fight? He got the stuffing knocked out of him. What's the best song to sing when you're preparing your Thanksgiving turkey? All About That Bass. Why didn't the pilgrim tell secrets in the cornfield? Because the corn had ears. What do you call a haunted turkey? A poultrygeist. Look, like these people can't hold their water. I'm Eric Marone, and that was Spit Take.
I got wet.
What's going on?
Turkey for me, turkey for you.
Let's eat turkey in my big brown shoe.
Wait, how do you know that song?
Anthony came and sang it to me. Actually, here he is with his Thanksgiving lyric prank.
Hi, I'm Anthony Quinones, and I'm going around campus seeing if people know that Thanksgiving song.
love to eat the turkey and my big brown shoe. Love to eat the turkey at the table. I once saw a movie with Betty Grable. Eat that turkey all night long, right? Yeah, bro. Yeah, thank you. Let's eat the turkey and my big brown shoe. We love to eat the turkey at the table. I once saw a movie with Betty Grable. You gotta eat that turkey all night long, you know? Thank you, bro. Hey, let's eat the turkey and the big brown shoe. Love to eat the turkey at a table. I once saw a movie with Betty Grable. You gotta eat that turkey all night long, you know? Thank you, bro. You have a good one, bro. You know, white meat, dark meat, you just can't lose. I fell off my mope and I got a bruise. Turkey's in the oven and buns in the toaster, you know?
So,
yeah. Yeah. Thank you, bro.
Students around campus aren't in the Thanksgiving spirit. I'm Anthony Quinones. Back to the studio.
I remember when I used to play soccer.
Me too, but kicking was always my biggest challenge.
Maybe Caesar could teach you how to kick like a pro.
Hi, my name is Josh, and I'm here to show you how to kick a soccer ball properly. So first, what you're gonna have to do is have a run up to the ball. Have your left foot, if you're a righty, on the side of the ball. And with your dominant foot, which mine is right, kick the ball with the laces part of your shoe. Run up, left here, dominant foot, kick. In order to hit the ball with power and action, you would like to hit it around this part of the area with your laces. If you follow these steps, you can kick a ball properly like this.
Thanksgiving is the best time to watch a movie with family, but I can't figure out which one to watch.
What about Freebirds? Here's Tyler with a review of the Thanksgiving classic.
Hey, what's up, guys? I'm Tyler, and for this week's movie review, we're doing Freebirds. This movie is great. It's the best movie you could ever imagine. The movie's comedy is so refined. It's just great. If I could give it a review, it'd be 11 out of 10. It's a perfect movie. It's about turkeys. It's like a cartoon, but it's about turkeys getting off the Thanksgiving menu. And it just, I don't know, I liked it a lot, and a lot of people did too. It's really good in my opinion. It came out in 2013, I believe. My favorite turkey is Reggie. He's the best turkey, hands down. Best turkey, turkey of the year, everything. This guy got everything. He's so good. Reggie, he's clumsy, he's quirky, he's not tall, he's short. He doesn't like corn, which is kind of bad because that's all turkeys eat. That's probably why he's so skinny, but yeah, so on. Reggie, I like him the best because, I don't know, he's like the sort of messiah, and he's cool because he doesn't really fit in and he speaks to the turkeys. A lot of characters in it. The turkeys are crazy looking, like, they all look different and stuff. Like, Jake is like the size of, like, I don't know, the biggest turkey in the world. He's huge. Not that I'm attracted to him at all, but yeah, Jake's great. Reggie's also very attractive. They're all very attractive, I have to say. I find them all stunning. And this movie does not promote vegans. It does not. You have to be a vegan to watch this movie. I'm not. I eat turkey. I just love them a lot. I love turkey. Yeah, go rent this on Amazon Prime, Netflix, I think it's on. I'm pretty sure it's on Netflix. It might be on Prime Instant Video. You should watch it. It's a great movie. Watch it with the family for Thanksgiving. It's great. Tell them Tyler from High Voltage from school told you to watch it. It's perfect. This has been Movie Review, High Voltage, Thanksgiving edition.
I cannot wait for Thanksgiving dinner.
Me either. My favorite dish is definitely mashed potatoes.
Let's see what the students at the Bear are having for their Thanksgiving dinner.
I'm Charlie Ritkus, and I'll be going around campus asking students what their favorite Thanksgiving meals are.
What are your favorite Thanksgiving meals?
I really like eating raw pig stomach.
I also like that, but on the side with mashed potatoes.
Fair enough. First
of all, I get a bread, like a big Subway bread, but not from Subway, like good Italian bread.
Turkey, I love turkey.
You like turkey?
Yeah.
A lot of it too.
Then I grab turkey, I cut it up, I put some sauce on it, put some bacon, and put some melted cheese, and that's where the good stuff's at.
Usually, it's just a typical Thanksgiving meal, like turkey, mashed potatoes, cranberry sauce.
So, what's your favorite dessert for Thanksgiving?
I take the leftovers and I make a pie out of it.
With mashed potatoes.
It's either like pumpkin pie, apple pie, or like something different.
Well, it seems that each of you have your own idea of what a good Thanksgiving meal should be. It's been Charlie Rutkus, and back to the studio.
And that's all for this episode of High Voltage.
Make sure to follow us on social media at Cyberspace CBTV and add us on Snapchat at Cyberspace TV.
I'm Kimberly Blum.
And I'm Angie Sobel.
See you next time.